Hi, I'm here with Bettina Warburg, co-founder and managing partner of Animal Ventures. Bettina, why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself and about your company?
Sure. We're basically a mixed shop. We do three things. We educate, we build, so we actually get our hands dirty and create prototypes with the technologies we work with, and we invest. Either in sort of startups or in other ventures that we spin out ourselves.
Okay, that's fascinating. Now, I've heard you speak a couple of times, and we're on the same page about something, and we're, one of the things that we talk about with our clients a lot is this notion of trying to have computers do what computers are best at and humans are doing what the humans are best at. And you talk about this vision, and it's so compelling to me about this world in which, you know, the machines are negotiating with each other and talking and creating value just within themselves. And tell me a little bit more about that.
I think people get kind of lost in sort of what's happening with every specific technology, and sometimes they miss that bigger picture around how we can think of new technologies creating kind of like a new wave in economics. So for me, the big story about AI, about blockchain, about the growing Internet of Things is really actually we're getting to a place where we're going to have sort of a new class of consumers, and that's machines and robots. And so thinking about it less as robots are going to take over our jobs or take over the world, and more thinking towards what does it mean when there's this whole new sector that's actually a labor force and a consumer potentially too, where they have wallets and have purchasing power, kind of shifts our thinking about what's going to be possible and how we're going to end up working together.
And how much more value can be created in aggregate, right? And you know, it seems like people are really afraid of automation and they're coming to take our jobs and that kind of thing, but that's a very that's a very microcosm look at things. It's not helpful. If you as you raise your level of awareness there, it's you get this much more humanistic focus that is really positive, I feel, and I love it. It's really exciting.
I think, I mean, it's one of the stories we don't hear enough in the media maybe is around, you know, we've had all of these rounds of automation multiple times in our history, right? There used to be human alarm clocks, right? So
we don't always pick cotton, right?
I mean, and those weren't easy jobs necessarily. So moving up into more creative work is not a bad thing. And I think there's going to be a really interesting change between how much we can do as a human because we have a lot of different kinds of tools and technologies that amplify and augment what we're capable of.
Well, Bettina, thank you so much for joining us. It's been such a pleasure meeting you, and good luck for the rest of your day.
Thanks so much.